Ladies and gentlemen, stay right where you are, because... there we go. You know, it's the last show. It's nice to have a memory. We'll be back with more Talk About Your Generation still to come. Welcome back. And so we come, as we inevitably must, to our last endgame of the season. What is endgame and how many points is it worth? Well, you should know the drill by now. Tonight's task and the points attached will be brought on by some bizarre creature like a panda or a ghost or something like that. Well, this week, because it's the last show, we thought we'd do something a little bit different. Because we have Kerri-Anne from Channel 9 and Will here from the ABC, we thought we'd have the endgame envelope delivered from an unrepresented network. All right, so we rang Channel 7, asked Andrew O'Keefe, he said no. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the host of SBS's new late-night underwater documentary series, Japanese spider crab, Hikuru Mifune. Hikuru, over here. Hikuru Mifune, ladies and gentlemen. And that's enough. All right, thank you very much. Indeed, here we are. Thank you, Hikuru Mifune. And tonight's game is worth 22 points, which means anybody can win.
We can do it.
Wow. And tonight, the question is, which generation is best at... building a snowman. Yes. Yes. You each have a snow pit, all right? You each have a snow pit. Man versus nature, the eternal battle. Man takes nature's life-giving flake of crystalline water and fashions it into his own image. In short, man plays God. Yes. But this crime against nature results not in some lumbering and murderous Frankenstein monster or golem of Prague. Instead, we have a simple man of snow who delights small children and adults alike. You got a scarf, you got a hat, you got a carrot for the nose, you've got a pipe, got coal for the eyes. The most impressive and most delightful and the quickliest built snowman will win tonight and the series starting from now. There we go. Well, I'm going to share you some interesting facts about snow and snowmen. In Mexico, a snowman is referred to by children as Señor Frosty. I didn't know that. That sounds chronologo.
Oh, it's actually snowing.
Isn't that nice?
Oh, that's nice.
All right. According to the latest edition of the official SAS survival manual, the best way to survive an avalanche is to try and jump in the air just before the avalanche hits you. Well... well, be careful, for God's sake.
I love that we're on a commercial network. If this was the ABC, we would just have some ice cubes in a tray.
Yes, yes. Well, we go all out here. Can I help you back? I don't want you to slip over. Be very careful. Be very careful. It's very, very slippery.
How long have we got, Sean?
You have another minute. Another minute to build the most impressive snowman that ever didn't live.
Start doing it.
Gee, it's getting cold. Isn't it getting cold?
Get the hats and stuff. I'll try and...
isn't that nice? Isn't it? What a beautiful... a beautiful fairy wonderland we've created here, ladies and gentlemen.
That is looking
very
good,
impressive. Generation X have built a lovely snowman. I can tell that you're about to insert the nose even as I speak.
Yeah. And, his eyes fell out! His eyes fell out!
That's right.
In the,
and the baby boomers are almost at the stage of dressing their snowman. That looks pretty impressive.
Jam,
pretty. We've got 10 more seconds. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, can you help us count down? 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's it. That's it. We are finished. And shall we inspect the snowman? Come with me, ladies and gentlemen. Let's have a look here. Well, it's a short snowman, but I think they're all a bit short tonight. Yes. Now, that's impressive.
Discriminate against him because he's short.
No, not at all. No. In relative terms, that snowman is a giant.
And we've tied this in a sort of a European fashion.
Yes. It's very impressive. And he's got his hat in a jaunty angle.
Yes.
And, he's a man about town. This one is slightly more erect. Now, you've put the carrot in backwards. That's counterintuitive. Usually, you go, it gets narrower rather than the the fat end with the green hanging out of it.
Although, he's got a cold.
He's got a cold, right. That's fair enough. Very impressive. Let's have a look at this one here. That just looks deformed. That's the elephant man. It's the elephant man of snowmen.
Yeah, we don't conform to your image of what a person looks like.
Yeah, you're right.
People come in different shapes and sizes,
Yeah,
Sean.
I'm hearing you, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Josh, with your present makeup on, you could have put the hat on you and you could have fooled me that you were the snowman. I've been very impressive.
We love him. We love him like he's our own.
I got to say, I reckon Generation X is the most impressive snowman. And they win. Trophy tonight to you, sir. And check for $7.50 to you, Will Anderson. Oh, please. Well, thanks to our special guests tonight, Kerri-Ann Kennelly, Will Anderson, and Josh Lawson. And also our team captains, Amanda Keller, Charlie Pickering, and Josh Collins. Stop it. Well, what have we learned across the series? Simply this. No single generation has a monopoly on knowledge or wisdom. Each generation has something to teach the other. Each has something to learn from the other. And in time, as the generations grow closer to the realisation... Well, I'm going to give you the wind-up now, so I'm sorry, I can't finish up. Until next year. Afterwards too. I'm Sean McAuliffe. Good night.